Welcome to CDOT's TETP Insights. During this Insight presentation, we will examine how to set up a Bluebeam Studio session and how to use Bluebeam's review tools. Studio Sessions is one of Bluebeam's many features that allow teams to review, markup, and collaborate in real time. Let's take a look at sessions in the Bluebeam environment. When you are in Bluebeam's main workspace, you'll see an array of commonly used tasks in the left panel. One of those panel tools is the Studio environment. When the Studio panel is expanded, you will be asked to sign in. If you do not have login credentials, after clicking on Sign In, select Create Account and you will be guided through the account setup process. If you already have an account, just enter your password. When Studio opens, you'll see two options that are available through the Studio environment. They are Projects and Sessions. Projects is a file management and storage feature in Bluebeam. Since we use other software to fill this need at CDOT, we will not look at this feature during this Insight presentation. The other option is Sessions. This is the powerful collaboration tool that we will examine more closely. When you click on the Sessions button, you'll see a list of sessions that you have been invited to. You are invited to a session via email when the project manager sets up the session. To create a new session, click on the plus symbol next to All Sessions and select New Session. Name your session, then select the Add button to add a PDF document to the session. PDF documents can be added from ProjectWise or your local C drive. Permissions can then be set for those invited, and there is an option to have the session expire at a specified date and time. This can be a helpful reminder for contributors to provide comments by a specified deadline. You can now select the OK button to create the session. A new window will then open that allows you to add contributors to the session. There are two options for adding contributors, individually by email address or by a user-created group. User-created groups are outside of the scope of this Insight presentation, but more information can be found using Bluebeam Help. Click on the green plus symbol to individually add contributors. Enter the invitee's email address, then select OK. The invitee you just added will show up below the email address heading. Additional contributors can be added using the same steps. Once you have added all of your contributors, an optional message can be added that the contributors will see with the session invitation email generated by Bluebeam. Select the OK button to send invitations to the contributors. Additional contributors can be added to the session at a later time by selecting the mail icon to the right of attendees. It is important to note that by default only the creator of the session can add additional contributors. Within the Studio environment, you will notice three subpanels in the panel area. On top is a list of attendees, which is a list of participants that have been invited by the creator of the session. By the way, attendees can be anyone within or outside of CDOT. Those that don't own a license to Bluebeam can still participate by loading the free reader version of Bluebeam. At the bottom is the record of events that have occurred in this session. Bluebeam makes an entry in this event log every time an attendee logs into the session and for every markup or comment. A daily update email is also sent to the creator of the session with a summary of the markups and comments made by attendees. The middle panel is a list of documents that have been associated with this session. Additional documents can be added by the creator of the session using the upload icon to the right of documents. A neat feature within the attendees section is the ability to follow another attendee. This allows you to see the page they are on and watch as they zoom, pan, and mark up the PDF. To follow an attendee, right-click on their name in the attendee list and select Follow Attendee. To stop following, you can left-click on their name again in the attendee list. When you select a document, Bluebeam retrieves it from the cloud. You can resize the panel by moving the border when the double arrow slider appears. To close the panel, you can collapse it by clicking the Studio button again. Or, instead of clicking and dragging it closed, simply single-click the panel edge when you see the double arrow slider. Now let's look at the cool things you can do in Bluebeam sessions. This set of plans has been marked up by the design team, including various specialty groups like traffic, utilities, environmental, lighting, hydraulics, and others. Local agency partners have also participated in this review and provided their comments. Powerful feature of Bluebeam is the Comments and Markups Log that is generated anytime a markup is created. You can view the database of markups by selecting markups in the lower left part of the Bluebeam workspace. Just like with the side panels, you can adjust the size of the markup's data viewing area by dragging the double arrow slider. Each markup on the plan sheet has a line entry in the markup's dataset. Because they are linked, if you select a markup on the plan sheet, the dataset will automatically move to the line associated with that markup. Similarly, if you select a line in the markup dataset, the sheet view will move to the sheet that the markup is on and highlight that markup. Markups can be easily turned on and off by selecting the I button. Because Bluebeam has created a data set for the markups, we can now do some very powerful things. When selecting the markups list pulldown and hovering on the columns option, we can see the columns that are available to view, and there are check marks next to those that are currently turned on. The markups can be sorted by any of the column data header criteria by clicking on the column header. For example, the data can be sorted by sheet number or by author. Additionally, if filters are enabled, the data can be filtered using any of the values in a column. Enable filters by clicking the funnel at the upper left of the markups panel. You will know it is enabled when a filter funnel is shown in the column headers. As an example, if we only want to see a certain contributor's comments, select the filter funnel on the author header, and then select the contributor's name from the list. You can move the sheet view to the sheet where the comment was made by clicking on the comment in the markups list. Another cool feature is that when you have filtered a criteria, all of the other entries in that column are grayed out on the sheet. When the filter is removed, all of the other markups on that sheet are activated and returned to full color. The status column is another useful feature with the ability to select from the following options for each markup: accepted, rejected, canceled, completed, or none. This is a good way to manage the status of comments and to help identify those comments that still need to be addressed. Custom columns can also be created. A couple examples include assigning discipline responsibility and priority level to comments. Creating custom columns will not be covered during this insights presentation, but more information can be found using Bluebeam help. Note that within a session, only the comment originator can select from a series of options or enter text for custom columns. The dataset can be exported to PDF or Excel if desired. External comments can be imported from other PDFs, but it requires a fair amount of effort and can be kind of clunky, so it is best if those marking up a document do it within Bluebeam. Finally, let's discuss how to add markups to a document. There are a few different ways to access markup tools in Bluebeam. One option is to select the Tools tab, then hover over Markup, which expands several different markup tools. Another option is to reveal toolbars by selecting the Tools tab, hovering over toolbars, and then selecting the desired toolbars. The Shapes and Text toolbars provide commonly used markup tools. Toolbars can be moved to either side panel or in the heading of Bluebeam by clicking and dragging the toolbar into the desired location. Markup tools are also available in the tool chest, which can be accessed by clicking on the toolbox icon on the left pane. The My Tools section saves preferences for different tools, allowing for more efficient markup. Tools can be added to My Tools by right-clicking a markup already made on the PDF, hovering over the Add to Tool chest, and selecting My Tools. By default, the exact copy of the markup is added to My Tools, and if selected will add the same markup. In most cases, it is more desirable to have the root tool as the tool available to select. This can be changed by double-clicking on the tool. Preferences for tools can be changed by selecting the tool and clicking the Properties gear. Using a line markup tool as an example, the color of the line, opacity, line style, line weight, and line terminators can be set as desired. The preferences set will apply for all future markups using the tool from My Tools. Another cool feature in the tool chest is the Recent Tools section right below My Tools. This section shows recent markups that you made to the PDF document. Repeating comments can be made much more efficiently by selecting the recent tool desired. Thank you for watching this CDOT Insights presentation about setting up a Bluebeam session and how to mark up a document as a team. Bluebeam provides a versatile and robust environment for document review and markup that is supportive of plan review. We hope that this insight training has helped you to see the ease and power of using Bluebeam to collaboratively review CDOT plans and other documents.